There's this strain of the transgender movement, namely the child beauty pageants. I'm sure we've all seen it with Desmond is Amazing, and also a lot of articles where parents are putting their kids on hormone blockers at age 6 or 7. Mm-hmm. I think it's child abuse. I think it's child endangerment. What can we do to combat this?
I think they're doing the best job possible to combat this by exposing themselves and exposing their wicked ideology. I think if you polled 100 people in this country and you said, hey, should we sexualize young children, put them in girls' clothing on a gay bar and have men throw dollar bills at them? Do you think that's a good idea? I suspect 99 out of 100 would say no. Same thing, should we take 4-year-olds and put them on puberty-blocking hormones and fundamentally change their biology because of some particular fad, some fashionable fantasy? I think 99 out of 100 would say no. It is child abuse. And I guess the one thing we can do is embrace the cultural battle. There is a divide on the right. Some people, they want to avoid the cultural battles at all costs. This would be the sort of Mitt Romney 2012 campaign. I'm not going to talk about anything cultural. I'm only going to talk about economic misery and letting people keep more of their money and growing some jobs, and that's it. And they hope to skate through. Nobody cares about that. Nobody cares. When you take the culture out of politics, all you have is bean counting. And nobody wakes up fired up in the morning to lower that top marginal tax rate by 0.2%. Yeah, baby, we're going to do it. Nobody cares about that. And we do care about the culture, because politics is downstream of culture. And so I would speak in very real cultural terms. I would call the parents who do that to their children sick perverts and child abusers. You know, they use epithets at us that are unfair and they're wrong and they have nothing to do with reality. They call all of their opponents Hitler or Nazis or fascists. We should use language precisely, and we should call them what they are, which is perverts and child abusers, and point that out, put them on the defensive. The best defense is a good offense, particularly in the culture. We've seen that in the last few years. I think we are winning that cultural battle right now, and the way that we're going to continue to win it and get more victories is by speaking clearly and forcefully.
Thank you very much, sir. Yep.